I'm proud to be an American Armed Forces veteran.
And veterans can be sons, daughters, mothers, fathers.
It's all about teamwork. It's selfless service, and it's all about the team.
A veteran could be anyone walking the street.
To maintain our freedoms and principles.
I was willing to step up and do what needed to be done.
Everyday people are veterans.
Willing to go forward with all that the country asks you to do.
You know, all veterans are a hero in a sense.
Though the U.S. military is no longer segregated, during World War II, discrimination was prominent in America and our armed forces. Though African-American soldiers played a vital role in World War II, it wasn't until 1997 that seven of these brave veterans were fully recognized. It was then that President Bill Clinton bestowed our nation's highest honor on them, the Medal of Honor. And even though many others were never recognized for their sacrifices, serving our country as a black soldier in the 1940s brought pride to many African Americans. One such soldier, William Rogers, sat down with us recently and shared some of his memories of World War II. Though he was stationed behind enemy lines, he still remembers the constant bombing by the Germans. He remembers how soldiers from his all-black unit volunteered to fight in America's largest and bloodiest battle during the war, the Battle of the Bulge. And he recalls how black soldiers serving as guards helped save America's supply depots at this most critical time.
They were jet bombs, and they looked like a little small airplane. And you could look up there, and you could hear this thing coming. And you look up there, and when it shut off, and it carried about, I think it was an 1,800-pound warhead in it, and it dig a hole about 20 foot deep when it hit. And I got those things night and day. Now, that's one thing that really got my attention. There was like little German pillboxes around, you know, that fortifications. And we used to play a little game called chicken. And as a bomb is coming in, when it shuts off, the first one run through that door is a chicken. So I think I was always a chicken. But anyhow, there's two incidents I remember. One was a guy from the infantry. I was standing there talking to him. And he was telling me, he said, you know, they sent me here for a rest area. He said, they got to be kidding. He says, at least where I come from, they don't shoot at you unless they know you're there. Here, they don't care. They just drop them anywhere and everywhere. He said, I'm out of here. So I figured then it wasn't a nice place to be. And then another time, I never will forget, I was watching this officer was coming across the field, and he heard the bomb coming, and he looked up at it, and it shut off, and he'd run this way and look back, and then he'd run that way and he'd look back. And boy, when he got up to where I was, he said, oh, I thought I'd bought the farm that time, you know. Being in the quartermaster, whatever they needed, that's what you did. And I wound up out unloading ships, ammo ships. We would go out on little amphibious trucks, they call them ducks. And the thing that got me about going out there, I never thought about it. I really didn't know how to swim, and I didn't have a life preserver. But I never gave it a thought. Everybody else was going, I went. Back in those days, you didn't get training for anything. Like they tell me, well, we're going to put you on a crane and, unloading nets down into the ducts. I didn't even know how. They had to come and show me how the thing worked. And the problem I had, the ones we happened to be loading at that time were Englishmen. And I kept telling him we could only put one net on, and he kept begging for more ammo. So we sunk it. Yeah, I'm still proud of being in the service back in 43 and where I went and what I did. But like I say, I wasn't in a combat outfit. I was in a combat zone the whole time I was there. And I always said I was a perfect target. But you had to have, without supplies, see, that's what broke the Battle of the Bulge. Couldn't get their supplies. Everybody wanted to show, I ain't afraid of nothing. And then we had guys that volunteered, because you probably never heard about it, but we had guys that volunteered during the Battle of the Bulge. And they went to fight in the infantry. They didn't have infantry training, but they still went there and fought. Another incident that happened, during the Battle of the Bulge, the Germans, as far as I know, they were that group, they were within, I think, 7 miles of where they were trying to get to the dump where we were at. And the Germans was dressing in American uniforms. So they pull our guards off and pull their guards off of the dump and put our guards on because they didn't have no black Germans. And they did capture one. The guy that caught him was telling me about it. The Jeep pulled up. There was a sergeant driving, a lieutenant in the back. And he said that the what's name stopped him, told him he wasn't allowed to go in. And the sergeant, you know, he got out and he's, you know, he talking about, well, you know, he had orders. And the guard said, I've got my orders and you can't go in. So anyhow, the lieutenant jumps out and says, you see these bars on my shoulder? And the guard says, I don't care what you got on your shoulder, I've got my orders. And so he told him, he said, you know, if you come in the front, he said, I'm gonna shoot you. So he called the OD. And they come down and come to find out the guy posing as a lieutenant was a German. The only problem I had from the war, which I didn't know, and just recently, I couldn't sleep at nights. I never had nightmares or anything. It finally come to conclusion it was from the buzz bombs. Because I would wake up at night, I'd be tense, and I'm sitting there listening. And then, so like I tell them before, I said, I didn't have a problem with it when I got out of service because I was partying. When I got married, I didn't have a problem because I was up with the kids. I didn't start having a problem till I was by myself. That's when it started. Then I start to notice I can't get to sleep. I do pretty good now.
That's our show for today. Remember, we enjoy our freedoms because everyday citizens, known simply as veterans, answered the call to fight for liberty. I'm Timothy Hilton, and I'll see you next time on American Veterans.